Okay, my dear students, very good morning to one and all. And in the last class, so welcome to VLSA class, VLSA design. So in the last class, we discussed about driving large scale capacitor loads. Okay, in the last class, we discussed about driving large capacitor loads. Okay, so in this case, we discuss about different delays for NMOS and CMOS cycles when the number of stages n is even. Okay, when the number of stages are even, we are having this this formula. Okay, we are having n is equal to even number. So depending upon that, so we are having these are the time delay for the NMOS cycles and also the time delay for the CMOS cycles. Similarly, if the n is odd, then you have to consider depending upon the logic interval, that means depending upon the transition of the input signal. Okay, with the transition of the signal from 0 to 1, you can use this formula for NMOS and this formula for CMOS. Similarly, if this transition from 1 to 0, you can follow this transition, this time delay formula for NMOS, and also this is the time delay for the CMOS circuits. Okay, so now because of this, this was just observed here, there is no symmetrical. Okay, that means the signals delays will be not delays are not symmetrical here. So because of this symmetrical asymmetricity, and there will be this asymmetry in the inverters, the conventional inverters, so what happened, there is a large delay problem will be very very high in this case. Okay, so that means the delay will be very that means large delay will be exist in the circuit, particularly when you are going to drive the capacitive loads. Okay, when you want to drive the capacitive loads, so what happen is the delay will be very very large in this case when there is a when there is asymmetry. So how to overcome this asymmetry in the circuit, okay, to drive the capacitive loads. Okay, for this we have one approach in the NMOS technology. We have one approach in the NMOS technology, that is we can use the super buffers between the stages. Okay, we can use the super buffers between the stages, right? So therefore, now let us consider the super buffer. Okay, what is the structure of the super buffer using the VLSA circuit, particularly NMOS technology. Okay, now let us consider, this is the, there are two type of super buffer. Basically, we are case NMOS NMOS circuits, we are using two type of super buffers particularly. So one is the inverting super buffer, second one is the non-inverting super buffer. There is inverting type NMOS in the super buffer and non-inverting type NMOS super buffers. Okay, so now let us consider inverting type NMOS super buffer. So this is the circuit diagram of the inverting type NMOS super buffer, right? So what is the use of the super buffers? To eliminate asymmetry in the conventional inverters. Okay, so this, because of this asymmetricity, it gives rise to significant delay problems in the inverter circuit. So whenever the inverter circuits are drive the capacitive loads, so it produces some delay problems. To eliminate these delay problems, we are going to use super buffers in the circuit between the stages. So now there are two type of super buffers. One is inverting type NMOS super buffers and non-inverting type NMOS super buffers. Now let us consider this is a structure of the schematic of inverting type NMOS super buffer. Okay, just observe the circuit here. To forget about the super buffer here, first it assume that this circuit is, for example, let us take this circuit is inverter, NMOS inverter. This is an NMOS inverter circuit. Okay, so without these connections, so this circuit is a NMOS inverter, right? So this is the enhancement mode transistor, this is the depletion mode transistor. Now, in the NMOS super buffers, we are having two extra transistors, the same type of transistor. Here the depletion mode transistor, here the enhancement mode transistor. N channel depletion and N channel enhancement. We can use the same type of inverter here. Okay. Similarly, we can use the same type of NMOS enhancement mode transistors. So, but instead of connecting the gate to the short circuit, gate to the source here, so we are directly connect this gate of this transistor T3 to the gate of the T1. That is the main thing you have to remember here. Okay, gate of the T3 is directly connected to the gate of the T1. Similarly, gate of this enhancement mode transistor is connected directly to the gate of the transistor, enhancement mode transistor in the inverter circuit, that is T2. Okay, this is the structure, and we are taking the output at this point. Since this is inverting type NMOS inverter, that means the output is exactly inverse of the input signal. If you go 0 here, you get 1. If you go, if you take play 1 here, you get 0. That means there is an the operation will be inverted here, right? So therefore, you can consider this is the inverting type of NMOS super buffer. So how the super buffers will be working in this case? Now just observe here. So in order to analyze these NMOS super buffers, okay, so assume that this is the transistor T1, which is the depletion mode transistor whose gate is short circuit to the source terminal, and this is the transistor T2, the enhancement mode transistor, and this T3 is the depletion mode N-channel transistor, and this is the enhancement mode N-channel transistor. That is, the transistor means MOSFETs, okay. Right, so now just observe here. So now let us consider what happened, how the circuit will operate from this case. Okay, so let us consider the input is depending upon the circuit. Now let us say depending upon the input transition. Okay, assume that a positive going and a transition at the input. Okay, that means the, let us take the positive going transition here. That means Vn is 1. When the Vn is equal to 1, so what happened? This transistor T2 will be enhancement mode transistor. This will be turns on. Okay. When this is turns on, so what happened? The voltage at this node bit drops to 0. Okay, remember that point. Okay. So voltage will drop to 0. Because this point, this terminal is connected, this output terminal of this drain of this transistor and source of this transistor will be joined together here. So the gate is short circuited to this terminal. So what happened? Whatever the voltage here, that will be transferred to the gate of the transistor here. And this transistor is on condition. At this voltage, this transistor is always in the on condition. Okay. The voltage at this point is 0 approximately. So that means the transistor will be on. Okay. When this transistor is on, so what happened now? This 0 volt is again applied to the gate of this transistor T3, because the T3 gate is connected to the T1's gate. Okay, the voltage at the T1's gate is equal to the voltage at this node. Because the transistor T2 is on condition, the voltage at this point is 0, approximately 0. So the same 0 volt is applied to the gate of the transistor here, that will be transferred to the T3 also. So that means the transistor T3 is in off condition. Okay, the transistor T3 is in off condition. Remember, okay, T3 is in the off condition. So now, what about the transistor T4? Because the high voltage at this point that will transfer to this gate is connected to the gate of the transistor T2. So this transistor is also in the on condition. Okay, this transistor is in the on condition. So what happened now? When this transistor is on condition, this transistor is off condition, the output will be drop to 0 very fastly. Okay, that output will be dropped to 0. So we are getting the exactly we did ground level. Okay, when the input is high, we are getting the output is 0, right? That is the case. Now let us consider the second condition, that is when the input is low, what happened in the cycle? When the input is low here, okay, remember this transistor is always in the on condition here, but also on condition. Okay, this voltage is on condition. Okay, because the gate is short circuit to the source terminal. Remember, now when the input is 0, So what happens, this transistor T2 is off condition, and the same signal be transferred to the gate of the transistor T4. So the transistor T4 also off condition. Okay, it is also in the off condition. So when Vin is equal to 0, T2 is off. When the T2 is off condition, so this voltage will be rise to the value of VDD. Okay, the voltage at this point is now rises to the value of VDD. Remember that point. Okay, when this is off condition, this voltage is connected to the VDD level. So the same voltage is again applied to the gate of this transistor. So that means the same voltage, the VDD here, and the signal will be transferred to here. That means this voltage is given to here in this case. Okay, and this extra voltage coming from this gate terminal here, the voltage at the gate is rises to twice the value of this VDD. Okay, twice the value of VDD. So therefore, this transistor will be fully conducts. Okay, this transistor will be fully conducts. So what happened now? The output will be suddenly rises to the value of VDD without any delay. Okay, very small delay. This output will be suddenly drop, goes to VDD level. So that is the main difference in this case. So voltage at this point B rises greater than the value of VDD level. Twice, basically you are having twice the value of VDD at this gate. Okay. So therefore, so what happened is the super buffer, this high voltage drives this transistor to very high condition. That means this output base suddenly drop to very, without any delay. Okay, there will be suddenly rises to the value of VDD. So therefore, so like this, the transistor will be suddenly dropped to zero, and also with a very small delay, and this suddenly rises to value of VDD with very small delay. So then we'll get there is no asymmetric in this case. So this is really able to drive the loads here, capacitive loads. Okay. That is the operation of this inverting type of NMOS super buffer. Right? So remember this point. Once again, I explain. When the input is zero, so when the input is high state, okay, when the input is high state, when the input is high state, hold on 1 minute, please. When the input is high state, so what happened? This transistor T2 is on, T4 is on, right? T4 is T2 and T4 is on condition, and T1 is on condition, but because this is the depression mode transistor, it is always in on condition because the VGS is equal to zero. When this transistor is on, the voltage at this node, particularly this is the output node basically. So the voltage at this point is dropped to zero because the transistor is short circuited here. So this voltage will be given to the gate of this transistor. At the same time, the gate of this transistor T2 is connected to gate of the transistor T1. So therefore, the voltage at the gate of the transistor T3 is zero. So this transistor is off condition. Okay, this transistor is off condition. So now, see, remember, we are not going to connect the voltage at this short circuit here. Okay, the gate is not short circuited here. That's why this transistor is not on condition at zero gate voltage. Okay, so therefore, so what happened now in this case? So what about this transistor T4 is on condition? So the output will be, if for example the capacitor is connected here, the capacitor will suddenly drop to discharges through this transistor T4. Okay, suddenly drop to this transistor T4. Okay, so therefore we get an exactly logic zero level. Okay, similarly, when you apply a logic high low voltage at the input, when you apply a logic low voltage at the input, so what happens? This transistor is T2 is off condition and T4 is also off condition because it's connected to the gate of this transistor. That means initially you can consider input voltage. Okay, so when this transistor is off, the voltage at this node rises to the value of VDD. Okay, so this voltage is applied to this point, and the voltage now in this case at this node is twice the value of VDD because this voltage also appear here. So therefore, this voltage and this extra voltage appear here. So this will be able to drive the large voltages. So the transistor driven into very strong condition. So therefore, the transistor turns on very fastly with very less resistance between the drain and source region. So therefore, the Vout will be dropped and goes to directly to the value of VDD without any delay. So therefore, like this, this is like this, so inverting to super buffer will work. Okay, so therefore there is no asymmetric will exist in the circuit, right? Next, go for the inverting type of NMOS super buffers. Okay, so this is the inverting type of super buffer. Okay, this is the inverting type of super buffer here. Now just observe this case. So we're not going to change the circuit. Only small changes, very little changes in this case. In the previous case, what happened? The gate of the transistor T2 is directly given to the gate of the transistor T4. But now here, we are going to interchange the gate of this transistor and gate of these transistors. Okay, gate of the transistor T3 and T4 will be interchanges now. So that means the gate of the transistor T3 is connected to the gate of the transistor T2. And the gate of the transistor T4 is connected to the gate of the transistor T1. There is the small difference. Okay, the only small difference is exists in the non-inverting type of NMOS super buffer. Okay, now how the circuit operate now in this case? The same structure, same method you can analyze here. Now see, this is the non-inverting. That means when you apply 0 here, you get 0. When you apply 1 here, you get 1. Logic 1. Okay, that means 0 means 0. 1 means plus VDD means you will get plus VDD voltage. Okay. So now what happened now in this case? When the input is high, once again you can start from input is high. When the input is high, this T2 is on. At the same time, T3 is also on condition. T3 is also in on condition. Remember, high state. Whatever the voltage you apply here, the voltage and also the extra voltage coming here, it becomes twice the value. So output voltage suddenly rises to the value of VDD. Okay. So therefore, we'll get exactly high voltage without any delay in the circuit. Similarly, okay. So what happened now? This is on condition. Already it's on condition. When this transistor is on, this the voltage at this node will be dropped to zero level. So zero voltage is applied to the transistor T4. Okay. So this transistor is off. So output is suddenly dropped, rises to the value of VDD because the transistor T3 is fully on condition. The voltage at the gate is not VDD now, it is more than VDD. Okay, so the transistor T3 is fully turns on. So it is suddenly rises to the value of VDD, providing very low resistance. So that means the capacitor suddenly charges to the value of VDD here. That means you will get exactly very sharp VDD level. So similarly, so that is the case. Now when the input voltage is zero is applied here, when input voltage zero is applied at the input of this transistor T2, so what happened? The transistor T2 is off condition and the same input signal will be given to the gate of the transistor T3. So this transistor is also in the off condition, right? This transistor is off and is also in the off condition. So therefore, so what happened? When this is off condition, so whatever the voltage at this point rises to the value of VDD. So therefore, so this is applied to the voltage at the gate of this transistor, so it also turns on. So that means what happened now? Just output will drop to zero. When the input is zero, the output is again, you get zero. So sharp, that means without any asymmetric, basically you will get at this point. Okay. So therefore, you will get the operation, that is the non-inverting operation of this super buffers. Okay, non-inverting NMOS super buffer. This is the operation of a non-inverting circuit. And remember the structure here. It's a very important structure. There are two types of super buffers here. One is inverting, another is non-inverting. Right? So that is the today's class. So there is a different type of different, that means we are having different NMOS arrangement. Other NMOS arrangement is also possible here. There is a based on the narrative task. Native transistors are also known as the native super buffers, and also we are having basically it is not recommended in some cases, is not available nowadays. So previously it is available and not available, so therefore we are having native, that is also possible super buffers. Okay, and remember another very important thing is kind of because of the non-inverting super buffers as shown in the row figure. Okay, this is particularly this circuit particularly realized by using the fan accumulator technology which are able to, because of this structure, they are able to, that means this type of superbuffer is able to drive the capacitive loads of 2 picofarad with a very small delay. That means very small, there is 5 nanosecond rise time, with very small rise time in this case. So it is able to drive 2 picofarads, okay, with 5 nanoseconds rise time, okay. So that's why this is the arrangement we are using in the NMOS structures, okay. So in the next class, we can go for the BiCMOS drivers. We'll see. Okay, I'm going to stop now.